Today I thought I would share with you some books that have come across my desk recently, and of course it just in time for Christmas, so maybe there's some great gift ideas. Now, I've seen that there's an interest in the era of the 60s and 70s, and I'm seeing more books and, in fact, exhibitions coming up. So for anyone who's interested in this period, I can't recommend highly enough this book called Simply Brilliant, which would be a great place to start because it looks at some 50 different designers from this era. And it is, in fact, based on an exhibition of the same name that includes the jewels from the collection of a lady called Kimberly Klosterman, who began collecting when others only saw big and ugly, and she saw big and beautiful. It starts by looking at the Goldsmiths exhibition in London in 1961, which was seminal in establishing this new style of jewellery and sharing it with the world. And it also looks at how these independent artist jewellers, all of them listed in here, then began to migrate into more mainstream companies such as Van Cleef or Chaumet and Piaget. And it really is great for anybody who's interested in this era and a really good starting point if you're thinking of collecting, because this is becoming a very hot area in the auction houses now. Now, still in the same era, it's a long-awaited-for book about the life of Andrew Grima, who is billed as the father of modern jewellery. Now, this book is about 400 pages, catalogues his life, his work, his rise to royal patronage, as well as the work he did for bigger houses such as Dunhill and Omega. And it is a must for anyone who is interested in this era, interested in collecting. And also, it's nicely put by Geoffrey Munn in the foreword. He says that looking at Andrew Grima's work is like a microcosm of what was happening in the world at this time, because he did so capture the spirit of the moment in a very permanent way. And there's lots of beautiful photography in his jewellery, which has now become so recognisable, but at the time was, of course, so groundbreaking. So this is definitely one for those who want to know more about the legacy of Andrew Grima. Now, another artist jeweller of the time is Betty Cooke, and this is a much smaller, unfortunately for me, tome, and it is called The Circle and the Line. And Betty Cooke was born in 1924 in Baltimore, and she's considered one of the great exponents of modernist design in jewellery, and it's deceptively simple but utterly charming. And this is, in fact, the catalogue to an exhibition that will take place in Baltimore next year in September 2021. And it is a great catalogue of her work, and also understanding her approach to jewellery and how it changed what we see in jewellery design today. So I think you'll recognise pieces like that. So utterly charming little volume. Totally different now. We're going straight into the moment with Carol Walton's new book called The New Stone Age. Now, Carol Walton is the jewellery editor at Vogue, and she's written other books, and they mainly focus on styles such as floral jewellery. But this one goes a bit larger scale, and it gives you advice and very lovely images on how to live with minerals in your home and around you. So it goes by colour, and it gives you ideas of how you can place crystals in beautiful ways in your home. So that's the latest work from Carol, and I'm sure one that would make a great present this Christmas for people who want to explore the healing power of crystals. Now, I've left the heaviest book till last, and this one celebrates 20 years of Victoire de Castellan at the helm of design at Dior Jewellery. And as we come to expect from Victoire, this is quite kooky in its approach, and it's divided into two parts. And the first part is a dictionary. Well, let me show you a picture of Victoire first. Here she is with her characteristic little bangs across her face. And she lists alphabetically her favourite words and concepts. And guess what? D for Dior. And there she is with Mr. Christian Dior, as imagined by her in her pencil drawings. And then the second half looks at her jewellery over the past 20 years, and it's fantastic photography against these very dark backgrounds. And it is, in fact, how Victoire displays her jewellery when she presents it. They're always in darkened rooms, and you have to peer into cabinets, but it really does make the jewels appear to sort of glow out from the background. And the photography is just exceptional. It really captures the brilliance of her use of colour, and it's almost as good as seeing the jewels themselves. So I hope you're inspired to find the right book for you or to gift to somebody this Christmas.